Hi dear learners, firstly I welcome all of the BSc third year analytical chemistry student as well as the chemistry student to this online learning platform. And in last lecture we learned about the IR spectroscopy, principles of IR spectroscopy, the different modes of normal modes of vibrations in a molecule, that is polyatomic molecule. And today now we are going to learn about the topic, that is what instrumentation and techniques of IR spectroscopy. In this lecture we are going to learn about the subtopic of IR radiation source of the in the what instrumentation. So firstly let's start with the instrumentation of IR spectroscopy. The instruments used for IR spectroscopy is totally different than UV and visible spectroscopy. The usual optical materials like lenses, windows, sample cells, monochromators cannot be made from glass or quartz because they absorb IR radiations. The IR radiation are less energetic and hence incapable of emitting photoelectrons from the photoemissive material. Therefore, ordinary photocells, phototubes or photomultiplier tubes cannot be used as IR radiation detectors. Thus, the instrumentation is quite different for IR spectroscopy than UV and visible spectroscopy, which you have already seen in the what second year, BSc second year. The following four components of IR spectrophotometer used by different instruments are described below. So, what is the different components, that is what IR radiation source, monochromators, sample cells and sampling of substances, as well as what the detectors. In today's lecture we are going to learn about the IR radiation sources, which type of IR radiation sources are used in the IR spectroscopy. What is the difference between UV and UV visible and IR spectroscopy is that in the IR instrument or IR spectroscopy, we are not used the usual optical materials like lenses, windows, sample cells, monochromators, because these what the components are made up from the glass or quartz, they absorb the IR radiation. The IR radiation are less energetic and hence incapable of emitting photoelectron from photoemissive material. Therefore, the ordinary photocells, phototubes or photomultiplier tubes cannot be used as a IR detectors. That is the what drawback of IR spectroscopy, and what is the difference between IR spectroscopy and usual UV and visible spectroscopy. So first component of this IR spectroscopy, see with the help of diagram what are the components of this IR spectroscopy. So this is what the IR source of IR radiation as a sun, like sun is the source of electromagnetic radiation. See, this is the IR source. Second, this is the reference solution, that is standard solution, and here is the sample solution. These solutions are placed in the what the sample cells. Here monochromatic system is there. What is monochromator? Monochromator means mono, means single, chroma means color. So monochromatic light contains only one type of wavelength, that is what the lambda, one type, single wavelength. So we use the prism or grating for the that the for the what purpose of getting monochromatic light, that is a monochromator. Here what beam splitter is there, and another one is the detector, and this is the readout system. We'll get the output of this spectrum. Then see one by one what is the radiation source used in the IR radiation. The infrared instruments require a source of radiant energy which provides the radiation, which must be intense enough for detection, steady and extend over the desired wavelength range. The following four popular sources of the IR radiation are the described below. What are the main characteristics of that the sources of IR radiation is that it must provide the radiation which must be intense. What is the condition? It must be intense enough for detection, as well as steady source of the radiation and extend over the desired wavelength. What is the desired wavelength we required for the IR radiation? So all these property possessed by the source is used for the IR radiation. That is what the IR spectroscopy as an radiation source for the IR spectroscopy. Then first four types of the sources, the different types of the sources, radiation sources as used in IR radiation. The first one is a Nernst glower. First radiation source is a what? Nernst glower. What is Nernst glower? It consists of a hollow rod which is about 2 mm in diameter and 30 mm in length. What is the measurement? That is what? 2 mm in diameter as well as 30 mm in length. And it is the hollow rod. It is what? Consists of a hollow rod with what? 2 mm diameter as well as 30 mm in length. The glower is composed of rare earth oxides such as zirconia, yttria and thoria. This what? The rod is made up from the rare earth oxides, that is such as a zirconia, yttria and thoria. So Nernst glower is a non-conducting at room temperature and must be heated externally to bring it in a conducting form. It is what? At room temperature it is non-conducting, and by heating it is what? Bring in a conducting state. The glower source is generally heated to a temperature about 1000 to 1800 degrees Celsius. It provides maximum radiation about 1.4 micrometer. So what is it? Is a initially it is what? The non-conducting. We bring it is a conducting state by heating it about what? 1000 to 1800 degrees Celsius. Then it what provides a maximum radiation with what? The wavelength 1.4 micrometer. The main advantage of Nernst glower is that it emits IR radiation over wide wavelength range. That is what the benefit or what the advantage of this Nernst glower. It what? Radiation of IR radiation over a wide wavelength range. The intensity of radiation remains steady and constant over the long period of time. And this is also another benefit. That is what? The intensity is a stable and what? Constant over the long period of time. One main disadvantage of Nernst glower is the temperature coefficient of What is the disadvantage for this nurse blower? Nurse blower, it is what a frequent mechanical failure because of the temperature coefficient resistance is a negative one. So this is the what drawback of this nurse blower. Therefore, temperature increases is very rapid and source gets destroyed. Hence, the electrical circuit must be so designed to limit the current as the temperature increases. So what happens when temperature increases? It is a what? It has a temp what mechanical failure because it is not the mechanically strong, because after increasing temperature it's due to the negative coefficient, that is temperature coefficient of resistance, it gets destroyed with increase in the temperature. So and the circuit is get damaged. So what will you have to do for the overcoming this, what the disadvantage? So hence the electrical current must be so designed to limit the current as the temperature increases. Temperature increase झाली तर करंट लिमिटमध्ये ठेवता आलं पाहिजे, तरच हा नर्स ग्लोअर आपण वापरू शकतो. व्हॉट इज द नर्स ग्लो दॅट डिसअडवांटेज ऑफ दॅट नर्स ग्लोअर? दॅट इज व्हॉट द रेजिस्टन्स, दॅट इज कोइफिशंट ऑफ टेम्परेचर कोइफिशंट ऑफ रेजिस्टन्स इज निगेटिव वन. दॅट इज so due to its less mechanical strength. So here what in the animation I'm trying to show how this nurse blower lamp is work. That is what the this atria, thoria and zirconia rods are used in the nurse blower. So has a temperature coefficient resistance, so low temperature, that is negative temperature coefficient resistance. So next is the what next source is the glober source. So a glober is a silicon carbide rod, usually about 50 millimeter in length and 5 millimeter in diameter. It is also electrically heated and has a advantage of a positive temperature coefficient of the resistance. That is what the what is the difference between nurse blower and glober salt? It has a glober source, it has a advantage over that nurse blower is that it has a positive temperature coefficient resistance and it has the high thermal stability than that of the nurse blower. While on the other hand, water cooling of the electrical contact is required to prevent arcing. It works at the wavelength longer than 0.15 micrometer and what the below that of 5 micrometer. That is what the about the glober source. That is what the it is a silicon carbide rod and has the diameter that is 5 centimeter or 6 to 8 millimeter diameter, and what length is 5 centimeter, or it can be varied slightly as a 5 millimeter or 50 millimeter length. So after this, the next source of radiation is the incandescent wire source. A source of somewhat lower intensity but longer life than the glober or nurse glower is tightly wound spiral of nichrome wire heated by passage of electrical current. A rhodium wire heater sealed in a Ceramic cylinder has similar property as a source. What is the incandescent wire? It is what the simply nichrome wire. It is wounded or heated by passage of electric current. A rhodium wire heater sealed in a ceramic cylinder has a similar property as a source, similar to the nichrome wire. So lower intensity IR source but longer life than the glober or nurse glower. A tightly wound spiral nichrome wire heated about 1100 Kelvin by an electrical current. A similar source is a rhodium wire heater sealed in a ceramic cylinder. Incandescent wire sources are longer lasting but lower intensity than the glower and glober salt. That type of the what the incandescent wire are coiled or wounded. So it is a nichrome wire, or what the alternative is for the similar source is the rhodium wire heater sealed in a ceramic cylinder. See how this incandescent light provides the source of the IR radiation, how this process. So next source of the IR radiation is the low cost double beam Perkin Elmer IR spectrophotometer source. The most recent infrared source has been developed for a low cost double beam Perkin Elmer IR spectrophotometer, which is the systematically represented below. What is it? Is what the zirconia silicate and then alumina. Is what this zirconia silicate alumina wire, then here saturated aluminum tube, then rhodium wire, then here what the solder, and what is the voltage? That is what the 9.2.9 volt to 30 watts is the what power for this. It operates at a 2 to 8 volt and 30 watts and develops an external temperature is about 1200 degree Celsius. It provides a radiant IR energy from, that is 2.5 micrometer to 25 micrometer. It consists of electrically heated rhodium wire surrounded by the packing of zirconium silicate or alumina. Outer cover is of this was sintered alumina tube and internal diameter of 2 mm and outer diameter of 3 mm. Then see what is the construction. This is what zirconium silicate is the outer zirconium silicate is what the wire surrounded by the what packaging of zirconium silicate or alumina. Outer cover is of the sintered alumina tube of internal diameter of 2 mm and outer diameter of 3 mm. So this is zirconium silicate plus alumina in the internal, and what is the outer what outer tube is made up from the what the sintered alumina tube, and inside that the rhodium wire is there, and it has the diameter is about 3 mm and internal diameter is a 2 mm. If you have any queries regarding this, please comment in the comment box of the YouTube. I will try to answer your queries. Thank you.